أعزائنا الطلاب، بنرحب بيكم في حلقة جديدة من برنامجكم تبسيط العلوم. وصلنا معاكم لختام شابتر 4 في السوليد جيومتري في مادة الماس، والنهاردة هنقدم ليكم مجموعة مختلفة من الأسئلة وطريقة الإجابة المثلى عليهم. بنتمنى يا رب تتابعوا الحلقة معانا، وكل الأسئلة والاستفسارات اللي انتوا حابين ان انتوا تتعرفوا عليها في مادة السوليد جيومتري في شابتر 4 هنقدمها ليكم النهاردة. معانا ومعاكم النهاردة مشرفنا في الاستوديو ضيفنا مستر عبد الناصر جابر، خبير مادة الماس بوزارة التربية والتعليم. مرحبا بيك.
مرحبا بحضرتك.
مرحب بيك معانا، ونقدر نقول خلاص الحمد لله النهاردة بنختتم مادة السوليد جيومتري. قول لنا أهم النقاط أو المحاور اللي هنطرحها النهاردة في هذا اللقاء.
بإذن الله إن شاء الله.
حضرتك ممكن تقول لنا بس النهاردة اختصار كده للمضمون بتاعنا عن إيه؟
طبعا هنتكلم عن الستريت لاين والبلين،
تمام،
والريليشن بتوين تو ستريت لاينز والريليشن بتوين تو بلينز اند ستريت لاين اند بلين.
جميل. طيب نبدا بقى مع حضرتك، شرح بسيط طبعا كالعاده في بدايه
تمام.
لقائنا، بعد كده بقى التطبيق عليه من خلال مجموعه من الامثله والنماذج اللي حضرتك حضرتها
ان شاء
لينا.
الله.
اتفضل يا فندم.
My dear students, we have here the straight lines and the planes in the space. Geometrical axioms. The straight line is well determined if we determine two points on it. That means that if we have two points and we will draw a straight line like that, we have to have A as a point and B another point, and we will draw a straight line with two arrows, as you see now. That means that the straight line has no starting point, has no end point, but doesn't enough to determine one point to determine it. We have two points to determine it well. So the straight line is well determined if we determine two points on it. Let's go to the next slide. What is the plane? The plane is a space is determined by one of the following cases. The plane has many cases to determine it. First, three distinct and non-collinear points. Three distinct different points. Here we have C as a point, B and A. We call this plane X. And with these three points, the plane will determine. The next one or next condition, the straight line and a point outside it. If we have a straight line at AB and a point doesn't belong to the straight line AB, then we have plane. So the plane can be determined by three distinct non-collinear points like that, C, B, and A. And if we have a straight line and a point doesn't belong to it or doesn't lie on it. The third condition to determine the plane here, if we have a straight line AB and another one DC intersect at a point, by these two straight lines, the two intersecting straight lines will determine a plane. So we have three conditions now to determine plane. Three distinct points, a straight line and a point doesn't belong to it, two intersecting straight lines. The fourth and the last one, if we have two straight lines like that, the straight line AB and straight line CD, and they are parallel, then it will be determine the plane. So we have four conditions here to determine the plane. First, if we have three distinct non-collinear points. Second, a straight line and a point outside it. Third, if we have two straight lines intersecting at a point, we'll determine as a plane. If we have two parallel lines, we'll determine another plane. So we have four conditions to determine the plane. For any point in the space, there are an infinite number of planes passing through it. If we have a point, there are many, any point here, like A, D, C, or B, or a point inside it or outside it, any point, can many large number of planes pass through it. The plane, what is the definition of plane? It's a surface with no ends, such that any straight line passes through two points on it, lies completely on this surface. What is the space? Space is an infinite number of points, contains all figures, planes, solids. Will study the planes and solids that you will study. So, if you please concentrate with me, my dear students here, we have this page or this notebook. It's a plane here. Okay? We have a plane here. We call it a plane, but it a part of plane here. Yes. Yes, my dear students. We have here a surface. This surface, we call it a plane. In fact, it is not a plane because the plane, it's large surface. Imagine that this side will expand, and this side will expand there, and this side will expand, and this side will expand also. So this page, or this surface, will be an infinite surface. And we call it plane, but in fact, it's a part of plane. And briefly, we call it a plane. Okay? This is a plane, and we have also a straight line like that. This is a straight line. These two rays, or two arrows, the arrow here and the arrow here, straight line, have no starting point and have no end point. But if we have a plane, the straight line is completely lies inside it, or contained completely by the plane. Okay? We have here in our life many, many planes. We have this plane, and this one may be parallel like that, may be intersecting like that, may be intersecting at a point like that. This is a plane, this one, and this third plane, intersecting at the point, and so on. So a point can many, many planes pass through it. Okay? Let's complete the slide now. Example here. We have a cuboid, A, B, C, D, A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. Meditate the following figure, and then answer the following questions. Okay? Write three straight lines passes through the point A. Look carefully at the point A here. Try to find out three lines passes through it. We have found that A dash A is a straight line passes through A. Another straight line, D A, here, and the third set line AB. Solution, it will be the same. AB here, yes, and AA dash, straight line, passes through A, and AD as a straight line passes through A also. Let's move to the next slide. We have the same figure here, the cuboid ABCD, A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. Write the straight lines passing through both of the points A and B all together. Look carefully to the figure and try to find out the straight lines passing through AB. Write the three planes passes through the point A. We will try also to find out how many planes or where is the plane are the planes passes through A. The solution, first one, what the straight line passes through the both of A and B? The passes through A, B, and B is just one straight line, which is AB. So we have one and only one straight line passes through the two points here A and B, which is straight line AB. And the second question, write three planes passes through the point A. Look carefully at the point A. We have here the plane A dash, A, D, D dash. This plane already passes through A. And look carefully now, we have another plane which is A, B, C, D. This plane also passes through A. And A, D, D dash is third plane passes through A. Maybe one of you say, where is A, D dash? Imagine it, or you can join it. So A, D, D dash is a plane because the plane can be determined completely by three distinct and non-collinear points. So A, D dash is the third plane. Let's move to the next slide now. We have the same cuboid here, A, B, C, D, A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. And we have a question here. Write three planes passing through both of the points A and B all together. So we have to find out all the planes which passes through the straight line AB. It must say AB and complete. So we have the straight line AB here. Solution will be AB B dash. We have here AB B dash is a plane passes through AB. We have here AB and also here we AB. So this plane will pass through the straight line AB. The next one is ABC. Yes, if we join AC, then we will have a plane called ABC and passes through the straight line AB. The next one is ABC dash D dash. ABC dash D dash. Yes, imagine that we have here ABC dash D dash, a plane, inclined plane here, joining between all these points, B, A, D dash, and A, and C dash. So these three planes passes through the straight line AB. The relation between two straight lines here in the space. Meditate the following figures and then complete.
تمام مستر عبد الناصر معاك ومع أعزائنا الطلاب هنروح لهذا الفاصل نعود بعده لاستكمال باقي هذا اللقاء وشرح مفصل لمادة الماثماتكس وتحديدا السوليد جيومتري ابقوا معنا مشاهدينا مرة أخرى مشاهدينا ومتابعة هذا اللقاء وحلقة جديدة من برنامجنا تبسيط العلوم بنتابع من خلالها النهاردة مادة السوليد جيومتري ونقدر نقول إن احنا وصلنا لشابتر 4 وهو ختام هذه المادة. كل الأسئلة كل الاستفسارات اللي انتم حابين تعرفوها أعزائنا الطلاب هتتعرفوا عليها أكتر ومجموعة مختلفة ونماذج مختلفة من الإجابات عليها. معانا عودة طبعا مرة تانية مع مستر عبد الناصر بنرجع ليك ومتابعتك الجميلة وشرحك الجميل لمادة السوليد جيومتري.
If we have two straight lines here, my dear students, these two lines may be intersecting at a point here, may be parallel, may be skew. What's the meaning of skew? If we have a plane here like that and a plane here like that, then the two straight lines here are skew because each one of them on different plane. They do not intersect at any point. They do not parallel. So the two straight lines now have many relation intersecting, parallel, or skew. Let's go to the first slide here. The relation between two straight lines in the space Meditate the following figures and then complete. This figure 1, we have here L1 and L2 intersect at the point A, so they are intersecting two straight lines. Yes, the two intersected straight lines are two straight lines lie in the same plane, of course, and having a common point, which is here is A. Okay, let's go to the next slide. We have here L1 and L2, and they are parallel. Parallel means they are not intersect at any point, and they have the same plane. So the two parallel straight lines here are two straight lie in the same plane, of course, if we have two parallel lines, like intersecting lines, have the same plane, and does not have any common point. And the last relation between the two lines L1 and L2, we have here L1 and L2. The two skew straight lines are two straight lines, does not contain in the same plane, and they are not having the common point. L1 here in a plane and L2 in another plane. So they are skew straight lines. The relation between a straight line and a plane in the space. Let's talk about that. Yes, please. We have here a plane and a straight line. Okay? We have here a plane and a straight line. Yes, this is plane and this straight line. Maybe the straight line parallel to the plane here. Sometimes the relation between straight line and a plane, they are parallel. So this straight line parallel to this plane and maybe intersect. Sometimes the straight line intersect the plane at a point. Okay, so let us meditate the following slide here. The relation between a straight line and a plane in the space, meditate the following figure and then complete. We have here first one. The straight line contained in the plane in the figure, one of straight line contained completely inside the plane. Let's go to the next one. We have here a straight line. What's the relation between straight line here and the plane? We will find the straight line is parallel to the plane in figure 2. Look at this straight line. Look at this plane. They are parallel. Now, look carefully to the straight line here. It intersects the plane X at the point A. Yes, the straight line is intersected with the plane in the figure 3. The relation between two planes in the space. Meditate the following figures and then complete. Before meditating and seeing the figure, concentrate with me, my dear students, here. Yes, please. We have two planes here. Maybe two planes will parallel. Maybe intersecting. But look carefully. Intersecting where? Intersecting in a straight line here. Okay, maybe if we have three planes intersect at one point like that, maybe intersecting like that. So maybe two straight lines parallel or intersect. Let's see the following. We have here two straight lines, two planes. The two planes here are coincident, one on the other. The two planes are coincident here. The two straight planes are intersecting here at a straight line AB. Yes, the two planes are intersected. The two planes here are parallel, doesn't intersect at any point. Example. Meditate the following figure and then complete. We have the figure MABC. The plane MAB, look carefully at MAB, intersect the plane MBC, MBC, at what? And the plane MBC, look carefully at MBC, intersect the plane ABC, ABC, at what? Look carefully, because the plane MAB here, MAB, and MBC will intersect at the straight line MB. Where MB? MB here. And look carefully to the names. We have here M and B in the first plane. M and B. And the second one, we have M and B also. So it's logically will intersect at the straight line MB. And the next one, the plane MBC here and ABC. We have BC here and BC here. So it's logically intersect at the straight line BC. Let's see the next one. We have here the same figure, MABC. And we have the straight line MB here. Look carefully at MB. Intersect the plane ABC. ABC. Think about it. We have a plane ABC and the straight line MB. And we have a straight line MC here. And another one, AB. Intersect at what? Think. The plane MAB intersect the plane MBC. Intersect the plane MAC. We have here three planes intersect at something. Think about it. Yes, we have now. The first MB and plane ABC here, MB and the plane ABC intersect only at the point B. Okay? We have also MC here, MC and AB, MC and AB, we have intersect at no point. So it's 5 because they are skew. Why? They are skew because each of them belongs to or subset from a different plane. MC here in a plane here, MCB, and AB here in another plane, ABC or ABM. So they haven't intersect at any point. So the solution set equals 5. The plane MAB, look carefully at MAB here. And the plane MBC, MBC, and the other plane MAC intersect only at M. Look careful at names. Here there is M, here there is M, and also the third one have M. So intersect at the point M. Pyramid and cone. Look careful at this. We have studied before the cuboid. Cuboid here have a square as a base and another square, another base, and the bases, the faces are rectangles. So we have rectangles here and two bases. Each base will be rectangle or square. When we will fold it like that, like a box, we will get a cuboid here. This is edge. This is vertex, this is a face. So we have a cartoon page here, and we have bases, two bases here, and we have literal faces. If you fold, we fold it like that, we'll find that we will get act like that. This is edge, vertex, and face. Also, we have a rectangle and two circles here. Think about them. If we fold them, what we will get? Yes? Try to fold this part, this rectangle here. Yes, we will get a cylinder here. If you fold rectangle and two circles like that, we will get a cylinder. Let's talk about pyramid. It's very important for us. If we have a square like that and four triangles like that, all of them are isosceles triangles, and we have a square at the base. This square, of course, we know that each all sides are equal length, and we try to fold the triangle and this one, and this one, and this one. We will get what? We will get a pyramid. This pyramid have a vertex here and square base. Okay.
جميل مستر عبد الناصر، بالتاكيد دي اخر جزئيه موجوده معانا في شرح النهارده او في لقاء النهارده، ولكن نقدر نقول ان لسه شابتر 4 في السوليد جيومتري محتاج من
ان شاء الله.
محتاج مننا تاني في شرح، وفي برضو امثله تاني، وفي اسئله جديده، صح؟
ان شاء الله.
طبعا سعداء جدا بلقاء حضرتك وجودك معنا النهارده، وكان شرح جميل جدا لاجزاء مهمه جدا ومحاور مهمه جدا في السوليد جيومتري. بشكرك يا فندم.
ربنا يخليك.
شكرا لحضرتك. شكرا. أعزائنا الطلاب، كنتم معنا وهذا اللقاء وهذه الحلقة من برنامجكم تبسيط العلوم، ودارت حول جزء هام جدا في السوليد جيومتري، وتحديدا هو شابتر 4. بكده بانتهت هذا اللقاء وانتهى هذا اللقاء، ولكن ابقوا معنا وانتظرونا ولقاءات جديدة في برنامجكم تبسيط العلوم. شكرا لكم.